Hey guys, it's Daru here. Welcome to our attic. In our next video, we'll show you how to take a standard flat ceiling and vault it. If your attic looks like this, you've got a gabled roof, and it's the ideal candidate for a vaulted or cathedral ceiling. Now, these are your ceiling joists, and these held up our original plaster and lath ceiling. Before removing your ceiling joists, you'll absolutely want to consult with a structural engineer. Your engineer will come and do a site visit and assess many factors, including these. By taking this extra 5 feet of attic space and adding it to our living space, our room will feel substantially bigger, brighter, and spacious. Now, whether you do the work yourself or you hire a licensed general contractor, you'll want to make sure that your structural engineer provides you with a set of stamped drawings. Your building inspector is going to want to see them, and you want to make sure that it's done right. How to spot that is quite simple. So our attic space right now is 5 feet. We have a standard 8-foot ceiling. So we're going to use all of this space in the attic will now become part of our living space. We're going to get rid of the ceiling joists that are currently holding up the ceiling, and we're going to follow the rafters for the new ceiling height. Depending on how your roof is structured, you may require collar ties. In our case, we don't. With your permit in hand, it is time to start your demo, so we can get started on removing the ceiling joists that held up the old flat ceiling. All of this is gonna have to be cut. Okay, perfect. All right, we're good. With our ceiling joists removed, you can really get a sense of this space. This room feels so much bigger and brighter. With our rafters exposed, we can now bring our insulation up to code. On our ceilings, we'll be going with spray foam insulation to achieve a minimum R31 rating. That's required here in Toronto. On our exterior walls, we'll be going with an R24. Check your local building codes to see what's right for your neighborhood. Spray foam is more expensive than standard Batt insulation, but in our case, it's gonna save us in our heating and cooling costs in the long run. This is also a great time to add more natural light. Install a skylight. That's gonna add a lot of natural light to this space and also draw attention to our new high ceilings. Well, I'm so glad we finally are insulated and we've brought everything up to code. The strapping on the ceiling, we now have R31 on the ceilings. We weren't actually allowed to do spray foam on this wall because we're too close to the property line. That's what our inspector says. So you just have to go with what your inspector says. And ultimately, this room is gonna be really big, really bright, and warm. I'm so happy about that, especially because it's getting really cold here. This is Canada. It's incredible. You remove these, it feels so, whoa. Danny's like, I wanna do this at my house. Thank you.